Hello, welcome to Back to the Mat. So we have a series of body weight exercises. We do everything for almost a minute. We do one round, go back and do it all over again. I'm not there to keep an eye, so if you have any injuries or niggles, just do what feels right for you. Skip an exercise, do something different, repeat, or have a breather till the next one. We're just going to make a start standing up and just, here we go. So feet, I hope width apart, just gonna take a nice easy shoulder roll. And we're gonna take two shoulder rolls. We're gonna take two of the hands on the shoulders, in, two circles back, and a swing, and then lift, and we're gonna take a little swing. So just keep it small, come back, and lift again, little swing, come back, arms down, and we repeat. Two shoulder rolls, two of the hands on the shoulders, two of the arms going back and back, two swings again, then we're gonna lift and swing, come back, and again lift and swing, come back, and one more time, shoulder again. Hands on the shoulders, lovely, arms going back, big circle in front, again, you're gonna lift. Just swing, come back, circle around, one more lift, drop, come around, and there we go. Just warming up a bit more, gonna take a little step knee. So you step forward, lift the knee, back. So you step forward, knee, back, and then again. Arms are just easily walking with the legs, as it were. Again, step, knee, back, step, knee. Variations on the theme. Good. Couple more. Last one. Okay, gonna take little skips on the spot and then some jacks. We're going 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 2 jacks. Good. Skip on the spot. Now, of course, if you don't want to skip, you can march. Wide open chest, lift, out, come back. Twist you out, again. Out, in, up, down. Side, and side. Out, in. Keep it going, side. Side, out, in, out, and down. Side, twist, out. And again. Let's have one more. Okay, so you're going to bring the hands into prayer. We're going to keep the legs quite wide. You're going to take a deeper squat and then take a curtsy. And you can come into a deep squat and take a low curtsy. And these curtsies can be as low as you want. They don't have to be that low. They can just be here. So, deep squat and curtsy. Always up to you how low you go on these curtsies. Again, dropping down. squat or as deep as that. You can do this all without going so low. So you can keep these here, or you can take them lower. Always take it to where you want to be. Good. A few more. Lovely. We've got the last one coming up. And give it a shake. So now we're going to take some lunges. Lunges back. So we're going to take one leg back. We're going to take three little pulses. We're going one, two, three, and then step the leg in. So we go one, two, three, leg comes in. So I'm going to have my hands here. One, two, three, step it in. One, two, three. And again. Two, three, step it in. Good. Now we're going to go to singles. One, two, good. Can you feel this leg's working hard? So you can keep your hands here. We can take them back and in. Or just keep them here. A few more. Oh, hard work for this leg. And these glutes. A couple more. Lovely. Three more. Two more. Last one. And good. Oh, okay. Other legs going back. And again, we'll start with the three pulses. So we're pulsing. One, two, three. In. So one, two, three. Or you can take the arms here. Two, three. In. One, two, three. Again. So make sure with these lunges that the feet are not too close together. Again. Okay, we're ready for the singles. Now starting to feel it here and here. Good. Arms can go down and up, or up and down, whichever you like, or they can just stay still. So always just keeping the arms working for you. Okay, variation on that theme, we're now going to take a lunge. I'm going to bring the arms here, I'm going to bring the leg in, and take it, whoops, not like that, to an eagle. And we take it again, so lunge, come back into an eagle. And again, or half an eagle, lunge. Bring it in, take it into that half eagle, and go back. Lunge, bring it in, half eagle, and go back. And again, this is quite tricky as a balance, for me anyway. And again, lunge, bring it in, hold eagle, and back, a couple more, lunge, come in, eagle, and last one, take a lunge, come back, and eagle, and reshake. See if we can manage the first one without a wobble this time. Okay, so leg goes back, bringing it in, eagle, that first one's always tricky. And again, leg goes back, comes in to eagle. Good, and again, leg goes back, comes in to eagle. And again, it's going back, and eagle. Good, a few more. It's going back, coming in, eagle. So if you have the legs too narrow, that's going to make it harder to get the balance, like I did a couple of ones ago. Leg goes back. And eagle. Couple more. Hold it. And last one. Goes back. And hold it. Lovely. And come back. And give the legs a shake. Okay, lying down. We're going to take just a simple bridge. So arms are going to be by your ears. You're going to come up into a bridge and down. Then you're going to do the opposite, you're going to lift the head and shoulders, chest to ceiling, and down. So you're lifting up into a bridge, and lowering down. Then you're coming up, and down. And again, bridge, and lower. Chest to ceiling, and lower. So we have a bridge. bridge, lower down, chest to ceiling, bring it back, go again, bridge, and lower it down, chest to ceiling, so the ribs coming up towards the hips, elbows are staying back, and down, and again, bridge, come back, and lift. Now you're going to bring the legs up. You can keep the knees level with the hips. Arms are staying down. You can have your feet and knees sit with apart, or you can have them together if you prefer. Just going to tap the toes. One. We're going to be alternating toe taps. That's all we're going to do. Now you can either keep the hands as they are, or you can bring the hands to the ears for a bit of support. Lift the head and shoulders up as you do it. Good. If you want to, lift a little higher and bring the arms off. You also can do that. So you're actually looking between your feet if you're here. A few more. So any version of these. And of course it can be with your head just resting on the floor as we started. Good. And tuck the knees into the chest. Have a little breather here. I'm going to bring the hands back to the ears. Now we're going to do the toe taps. We're going to take elbow to opposite knee as we go. One, two, three. That's all. Over and over and over and over and over and over. Keep going. So always going up and over for these. Up and over, up and over, up and over. Think of leading with the chest rather than the elbow, although that's what's going to touch. And keep going. Lovely. A few more. Good. About 10 seconds left. Good. Hug the knees in, pushing ourselves up, and we're coming back. I'm going to start with a step knee this time. I'm not going to do the shoulders. We've done that enough. Okay. Step knee. Step knee. Easy step knee. Good. Keep going. Step knee. Lovely. Keep going here. And again. Vary the speed. You can even do a little hop if you like when you do the knee. So you can take a step hop or not. Up to you. A few more. Perhaps another two. And last one. Okay, now we've got the skip and the jack, or the march and the jack. So skip. Or march. Good. And keep going. Lovely. Okay, legs wide. So we've got these plié squats with the arms. So one side, other side, out, lift. Again, twisting. So you're twisting from the waist, your knees and hips are not twisting. Good. And again. Open chest, lift. last one. Alright, good. Legs perhaps a little closer. Hands in prayer to begin with. We're taking the squat and then the lunge. Squat and lunge. So again, you take these as deep as you like on the squat and on the curtsy. You can do them much smaller, just do them like this. Or you can take them bigger. But you choose whatever feels right. Just be careful with your knees. So if doing a wide squat and a long, deep curtsy isn't right for your knees, just keep it smaller. Just keep it like these. Or going the whole way. Or keep it smaller. And give your leg a shake up. Okay, so we're going to do the lunges with the pulses and bringing the leg in. Feet hip width apart. Try to keep that distance as we take the lunges back. So we've got three pulses to begin. We have one, two, three. That alignment of the knee over the middle of the foot. And shake the leg out. Okay, other side. I'll start with the feet hip width. Leg goes back, trying to keep that distance between the feet. Three pulses. One, two, three. Come back. Again. One, two, three. Come back. And again. One, two, three. One more like this, and then getting ready for the singles. One. I'm not going to count, I'm just going to keep going. Good. Lovely. Keep going. Feeling it on the opposite side. And again, a few more. Nearly there. Now we've got the lunge with the eagle, half eagle balance. Let's see if I can do it better this time. So, taking the leg back into a longer lunge, and then bringing the arms in, and take the leg across, calmly. And taking it back again, legs going back. So bring the arms in, and take the cross. Good. And going back, leg goes back. Coming in. Cross and a couple more. Legs going back. It's coming in. Crosses over. Excellent. Leg goes back. It's coming in. Crossing over. One more time. Leg goes back. Comes in. Cross over. Good. And give it a shake. Okay, other side. Let's have. Leg goes back. Coming in, crossing over. Bit of a wobble you on that one. And again, leg goes back. Arms coming in, and the leg crosses over. And again, leg goes back. Coming in, crossing. Good. Do it again. Leg goes back. Coming in, and then crossing it over. And doing it again. In, cross it over. Good. A few more. Leg goes back. It's coming in, crossing over. And again, it's going back. It's crossing over. Last one. Going back. Crossing over. And give the legs a shake. coming down. So we've got the bridge with a simple crunch up. So feet hip width perhaps, bridge up and down. Chest lift and low. So when you're doing the upper body lift, think about leading with the chest so you're not pulling on the neck and down. And again, bridge and low and lift. And again, lifting, lower, up with chest leading and down. And again, bridge and lower and lift and down. Doing it again, bridge and down. Lift, lower. Okay, lifting the legs, knees in line with the hips, and we've just got toe taps. So, hands by the ears, do you like, lifting the head and shoulders up. Arms reaching forward, lifting the upper body a little bit higher, looking between the feet, or supporting the head, or keeping the head on the floor. It's completely fine. It's whatever you want to do. We're going to take these a little bit quicker so they become more like scissors. And you can start on this round to just stretch the leg up if you like doing that with whichever variation you have of the upper body. Good. Couple more. And hug the knees in, quick stretch, quick release rather. Hands by the ears, bring the legs back to where they were. And we've got toe taps, but this time with elbow to opposite knee. So we're going over, 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 over. And again, if you like to do these with straight legs, and you feel warmed up enough with straight legs, carry on. Or just stay with the legs bent, or somewhere in the middle of the two. So straight, bent, do something between the two so that one is stretching, one is bending. They're both bent, or they're both stretched. Whichever version you feel you want to do at this particular moment in time. A couple more. And then just hug the knees in, have a little breather, hold it there. Just push yourselves up onto your sides. Bring your hands under the shoulders. I'm going to take a final plank just before we go to stretch. So it'll be in for about 45 seconds. So, zip up your pelvic floor, feel the muscles that wrap around your waist, tightly wrap around. Stay. Fingers are spread wide, pressing through to the heels. Your head is forward of your hands. The lift of the belly button, perhaps it lifted the shoulders as well. Good. 20 seconds left. Lovely. Keep going. Just a bit longer. Brilliant. Good. And now you're going to push your bottom up in the air. You're going to press one heel into the floor and then the opposite leg's going to come through. I'm just going to come into a pigeon. So your foot comes forward, the other leg's reaching back, and then you can drop the elbows down or drop the whole of the upper body down if that works for you. So you're just releasing, trying to get this side into the floor. So you're trying to get that buttock into the floor. You can put a cushion there if you prefer, and if it doesn't reach, that's fine. You can always use cushions or even a book to sit on for this. If you like to, you can reach your arms further out. Relaxing the head down. Good. Holding it here. I'm going to slowly start to come out of that. You're going to bring the hands down. You're going to tuck the toes under. Push back, and you're going to stretch the calf of the other leg, and press that heel down. and then the leg comes forward, comes through, and that leg goes back. So one side's always going to feel different to the other. So this one might feel easier or less comfortable than the other side. Doesn't matter, it's always different. And then if you like to drop the elbows, drop the elbows. If you like to reach the arms forward, do that. Entirely up to you. Holding it where it feels good. And if it doesn't feel good to drop down, then you can stay up. Hold it, and again, you can have something to support. So you can use a cushion or a book underneath your bottom, underneath that side. Lovely. And then it's going to bring the legs round. And we just have a final reach forward. Lift the arms up. Take a deep breath in, breath out, just going to reach, reach. Okay, you can have a little bend in the legs now because we haven't done a lot of stretch on the hamstrings, but we're stretching them now, so taking it nice and easy. If you want to just relax the arms and relax the head over and stay there, that might be enough. Or you can always ease forward a little bit more if that feels good for you. Always taking it only to where it feels right for you, of course. Relax your head, relax your neck, stay where you are, a little bit longer. Couple of breaths. As you breathe out, release a little bit further perhaps. One last breath. And then roll it up. Lifting the legs around. Dropping back. Just drop down into any version of ragdoll. That could be with legs straight or bent. Just give your head a bit of a shake. You can have a little bit of a sway. But then we're just going to bend the knees, unroll, circle the shoulders,